Hello friends, welcome to Data Visualization using R and ggplot2. In this session, we are learning circular bar plot. The name suggests something highly technical, but it's not. Like lollipop plot, this is an alternative to bar plot. It uses the space efficiently when there are more bars on the plot, making it crowded and untidy. It's worth learning the code necessary to get this plot just for this advantage. But if you have less than 20 bars on the plot, then don't go for circular plot. The data format is just the same as bar plot. There are few modifications in the code to make the axis circular. That is, ylim is added and polar chord is added. I will repeat this. The coordinate system is changed from default Cartesian coordinates to polar coordinate, which is circular coordinate system. Package ggplot2 is required to plot circular bar plot. We'll run this command installed at packages ggplot2 to get it installed. Alternatively, through tools, install packages and type name of the package, and this ggplot2 package can be installed. Click install, it will get installed. I have installed it, I will not install it again. Load the functions of ggplot2 by calling the library ggplot2 run. We'll start with creating the data. I will simulate example of a class name, and I will use here function letters to generate a sequence of alphabets 1 to 26, all 26 alphabet. Run this, and 26 alphabets are there in the vector name. Then score of these 26 students, score, I will use the function sample for that. First argument for sample is the range from which we want to sample. The students have scored 10 to 100. And we require 26 numbers as score of 26 students. I will run this. And now we'll store these two vectors in a data frame df data.frame name score. We'll see the data frame, run this and see the data frame. This 26 student score is there in the form of a table. Call the function ggplot. First argument of ggplot is the data frame from which our data is coming. Then aesthetics mapping AES, x axis will be mapped to the vector name. Then comma, y axis will be mapped to vector score. And we'll add the geom bar, geom underscore bar. And we'll run this to get bar plot. Here stat is required. Error says that stat is equal to identity, so that exact score will be plotted. Bar plot is there, but this bar plot color is not there. We'll add the color. Fill aesthetics will map to name of the student. We'll run it. And now this bar plot is there. We'll remove the legend by using theme argument, theme legend.position is equal to none. Legend will not be there. Now this bar plot is the base for our work. We'll add y limits, that is very essential, remember that. And here first I will put 0, then maximum marks are 100. I will put that 100 here and we'll run this. Nothing changed. Along with this y limit, we'll add chord polar, and we'll start chord polar start from 0. We'll run this and we'll see the effect. If we add space at the center of this plot, then it will look beautiful. We'll add that space by starting y limit with minus 50. You can have your own number to determine size of the circle. This empty white circle is there. It's looking good. The plot will be more informative if we order the plots as per their heights. Here I will use the package library dplyr for this. If you haven't installed it, install as I shown. Then here we will use the function reorder before the x-axis, reorder name bracket comma according to score bracket complete, and this much code is sufficient to order the bars, and the bars have got ordered. Other customizations also can be done. Very long names can also be arranged properly, positioned properly using little advanced code that we will see in other videos. That's all for this session. Till then, practice the plots. use the power of R and ggplot2. Happy coding. Thank you for watching this video. Press the like button if you have liked it. Your likes will be a motivation to make more such videos. Share with your friends or use it to teach to your class. And if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe it. Thank you for watching.